Hi everybody, and welcome back to a new episode of Chat with Kat. Today's guest was a Broadway prodigy. He began working at 12 years old, touring with the production of Black and Blue. Soon after, he joined Bring in the Noise, Bring in the Funk, and at 16, he co-choreographed his first musical, Wild Women Blues. Since then, he's contributed choreography for Broadway's In the Heights, Hot Feet, and The Wiz at the City Center Encores. He also choreographed many stage productions, such as Oklahoma, The Wiz, Priscilla, Queen of Desert, Singing in the Rain, and Sophisticated Ladies. No stranger to the stage, an incredible dancer, tapper, and percussionist, his love of musical theater and passion for commercial dance is what encouraged him to expand his field of work. He has collaborated with such artists as Janet Jackson, FKA Twigs, Beyonce, Pink, Camila Cabello, Gwen Stefani, Mariah Carey, Chris Martin, Queen Latifah, Taylor Swift, Miley Cyrus, Frank Ocean, Nelly, CeeLo Green, B.O.B., and Flo Rida. The rhythmic and ever so witty Dominique Kelley. Yeah. Yeah. I'm so happy to have you, Dom.
Thanks for having me. I'm
really, really excited to have you and to share this moment with you.
Me too, this is great. And just reminding you, we met 10 years ago. Grammys in Vegas.
Like, what?
In a dress room situation. So it's like, oh
my. Wow.
Can you believe 10 years?
I think that era of my life was like the make it work. Everything was like, make it work, right?
But you're making it work.
Well, I want to get into the questions with you. I'm so excited to hear about you and your life. I want to know, was there a moment that you went, okay, I'm doing this for the rest of my life?
Definitely. There was definitely a moment like that. I was always an active child. Like, I used to tumble. I used to play basketball, t-ball, football, the double dutch. Like, you name it, I pretty much at least tried to do it. I was even, like, going to the zoo all the time. I went to the museum every Saturday, but the one moment that caught me was my mother, who's a music teacher. She worked for elementary school and high school.
Oh, cool.
And brought in a dance company for her students, and I remember for an hour I was captivated. I didn't move, I didn't blink, and in that moment I was like, oh, I want to do that.
Wow. I mean, and your mother being a musical teacher, clearly it's in your bones.
Yeah, she was like technically my first dance teacher. Salsa, merengue, electric slide, the butterfly, like you name all the popular dances that you were teaching me.
That's awesome. Okay, is there, and I hate the word best and favorite, is there like a really great career moment that you hold dear to your heart?
There's been a lot of great ones, but I think of a couple first and foremost, for the culture.
Yeah.
It's Prague. I played the villain, Dr. Facilier, the body, and it was the hardest job I've ever done in my career.
Wow.
There's the hardest, because not only did I have to be the physical movement, like if you realize that cartoons never stop moving, whether they're talking or singing or dancing, they're moving constantly. So imagine that.
Wow. And then
the villain, I was his shadow, and voodoo dolls and other characters too. So it's like, it wasn't CGI. They literally filmed me doing all those things. So, you know, I tried to put any Dominique Kelley signature loop as I could.
Wow. It's the ultimate musical theater experience for you, being someone that had done it for so long already.
For sure. But what was different is usually in musical theater, I use my own voice.
Oh.
That I was lipping the voice of Keith David, who voiced Dr. Facilius.
Wow.
Other extra.
Right, like learning the cadence and following along. Wow.
Up together was hard. Another time where I got to play myself was Fame in 2009, that Marguerite Derrick's choreographed. And it was great because I didn't go to school, like high school formally like that, because I was performing. Wow. So it allowed me to go to a performing arts
high school.
Use every tool in my toolbox. There was tap, jazz, African ballet, partnering, freestyle moments. It was just wonderful, and we were treated like stars.
Oh, wow.
on the set, and we were treated with respect. Kevin Tancherone directed it, and it was just, it was great. It was one of the best.
I really believe in that. A film, like, there's really no treatment or experience like that, right?
No, not at all, because you depend on yourself. Oof. There's no hiding.
Is there a favorite thing for you to create for, whether it's film or live stage, commercial, television? Is there a favorite?
I feel like that's almost like picking your favorite best friend. Ugh. Like, really hard, but I do enjoy creating for live theater. I think it's fun. Usually you have a 6-week process of workshopping and figuring out what works best, and then you have the script to help you out. You have the costumes, you have the music and all that. And I like to say, when you can't talk about it and when you can't sing about it, you need to dance it. Mm-hmm. And I love to have those parameters and figure out where we are in the world in an emotional experience and what my choreography can add to that.
That's how you approach it then. It's like a language on its own.
It has to be. Mm-hmm. I mean, at the end of the day, you're just telling stories. It's not a certain genre. It's not anything. It's just storytelling as genuinely as possible and for an added entertainment, like, punch.
Wow. Did you have a favorite musical growing up?
I did have a favorite musical growing up, ironically. I mean, I watched so many different things, and my parents took me to New York City all the time, being from Connecticut, and we had local, you know, big theaters in Connecticut, which helped too. Entertainment used to be my jam, or PBS, and just like watching as many things as possible.
Wow, incredible.
Because you're telling a story, TV, film, with a recording artist, you still have maybe 5 minutes or less to tell that story in really visual. So I just like storytelling.
Beautiful, you do it very well. Is there anything that you've maybe changed your opinion about entirely that, you know, you even surprise yourself now looking back, like, wow, I really thought differently back then?
Since I'm such like a thinker in a way, but I love to like see what I feel, I used to think that I can just, you know, try it and go for it. But I've been realizing as I get older and older, research helps. Mm-hmm. And not only does research help, research allows you to form your own opinion. So if anybody else tries to weigh that, you will at least have educated facts to back that up.
Wow. I think that's such a good point too, based on like how overly saturated we are with things that often people don't even know why they do or don't feel ways, right?
Yes.
It's just there.
When you watch anything, instead of being like, oh, I loved it or I hated it, if you can tell yourself or anybody else why or what you would change, I think that's when you turn a negative into a positive.
Yes. Dominique Kelley's autobiography's title, what would it be?
D, all of the above.
Ooh.
And number one. Yeah, how quickly that came out.
You're like, I've already spoken to my publisher.
Yes, I'm already trademarking.
Is there like a reason for it? Does it mean something?
Well, D as in Dominique.
Great.
And then all of the above, because not only do I try to like master a lot of different genres of dance, but also, you know, the different aspects of life and, you know, the different media to express myself in, because I try to really do it all and do it all to my best ability. So D, all of the above.
I love that. If you have to do a TED Talk today, what could you talk about for an hour with zero preparation?
I think I can talk about working smarter. I think part of working harder is working smarter, and I think all of the aspects of that, and you know, I'm such a research crazy anyway, but I think like working smarter, because that's one of my favorite things to do. Like, for example, if you're injured, by learning the choreography with just your hands or by sitting down, so by the time you stand up, you'll be able to do it. Working smarter, so whenever you're in the situation, you know what to do.
Yeah, that feels like the ultimate preparation, right? Like, always be prepared.
Exactly.
I like that. Okay, what is something that people obsess and love so much and you just can't get into it?
Ooh, this is going to be controversial. I would say sometimes non-technique-based contemporary. It's one of those that I've been trying. Again, this is like my sushi, shrimp, avocados, tomatoes, iced tea. Those are things that I've been trying every year, hopefully, that I will like.
And it doesn't happen?
It does. Living in LA, my life would be so much easier if I non-technical bass, contemporary, and all those flutes that I listen.
They're always there.
Always there. Always popular.
Now, what you don't like about it, is it more like the title? Because the title doesn't make sense with what it is?
I think so. I think my brain goes to contemporary ballet, and I think of lines, I think of A, I think of NDT, I think of Cedar Lake, I think of those people making shapes as opposed to street jazz with no shoes on.
Okay.
It is.
Okay, I have a fun one. How does one win a gold star with Dominique Kelley?
Two things.
Okay.
One, working hard / working smart, and improving. Improvement is my favorite thing ever. If you start off in one position and then gain knowledge or ability, that's my favorite thing to see. I don't need to see anybody at their peak all the time. If I can see somebody learning and improving, that is my favorite thing ever. Even when I teach class, I tell people, come with one thing you want to work on. Take the power away from me, because your self-esteem shouldn't be based on if I like what you're doing. Work on one thing, and then at the end of it, if you at least work towards that, you've improved.
Yes. Based on what, you know, this like global pause and the unfortunate circumstances, has it allowed you time for anything that you're like, I would have never been able to do this had this not be happening right now?
I am watching on Broadway HD, I feel like I'm doing an ad for them, one musical a day.
Wow.
Educate myself about what's out there, because I wouldn't have had the time or the money to watch every single musical. And I feel like I'm on number like 23 or 24 now. And I just take notes. I know who the choreographers, the lyricists, the librettos, the directors, all of those things, and just keep a tab for myself and then compare it to other musicals I've seen.
The research, right?
The research.
I love it. Thank you so much, Dom, for taking this time and for opening up. People want to know how you think, and it allows them to make their own thoughts. So hearing from you is incredible to have an educator like you in our community, in our industry is, I think, beneficial for all of us. It's very inspiring. And the way you're bringing jazz to the forefront, it is accessible, it's exciting, it's scary. Like, I want to take your class all the time, and it's always before I teach, and I'm like, I'm not going to be able to move tomorrow.
Of course. No, you will be sore.
I will be so sore, but I want that in my life. Can we get an IG class?
That might be able to happen.
I think we need to get a jazz IG live.
I mean, hopefully we won't be kicking over furniture and knocking over our TVs, but we can figure something out.
I love that. Dom, thank you again. Have a good day.
Thank you.
Bye.